You recognize the man at once. It's Mazov, the cast-off artificer you met in Zirian Dayworker's Mere. Your first thought is that the Bloom has somehow released the wrong man, but no. The Memovaria deceived you. Ishen is Mazov. For the moment, Mazov is recovering from his ordeal, barely aware of his surroundings. He hasn't even seen you yet. Stay focused on the heart. The Bloom tongues are still stubbornly attached to your body. The Bloom voices make a final, violent foray into the depths of your mind, and a memory surfaces. Oh. You stand with a woman upon a circle of gold, the sky clear and blue above you. Meal Avast. The woman is well known to you. The same woman who helped you choose this spot years before. The same woman who built this enclave with you, together. Her face has changed, ravaged by time. The flesh is rotting away, exposing the glistening muscles beneath. Ugh. Well, you'd be right at home in here. You're disgusting. She turns away from you, as if to hide her ugliness. Not even your handiwork is proof against time. No, Marilel, you say. I have no way of fixing you, but you need not live in shame. You present her with a mask, its expression enigmatic, decorated with intricate patterns of gold. You know that reminds me of the mask of the being, basically the logo image of this, of Torment, Tides of Numenera. Has somebody with a mask, but you, it looks like either taking the mask off or putting it back on, either one. You just barely see, like, the face of a cadaver underneath it. Okay, that was fun. I had to restart the game, but I couldn't record it all until I restarted my entire computer. I don't know what the hell happened. Anyway, back to this. Right. No, Marilel, I have no way of fixing you, but you need not live in shame. You present her with a mask, its expression enigmatic, decorated with intricate patterns of gold. A pretty thing, she says, unable to hide the bitterness in her voice. I can just as well wrap my face in bandages or cover my head with a sack. By the way, I did everything the same. I had saved right before I went into the Bloom the second time, so luckily after that combat scenario. So, yeah, basically I did everything the same. For every intellect thing, though, I did one less effort, so... Because I don't think I got any stat pools restored or anything like that, so... Still end up with 9, I think that's 7 the first time. She holds the mask you gave her. Put it on, you hear yourself say, and she places the mask over her face. At once it seems to meld with her flesh, and her face becomes that of a lovely young woman. Her eyes widen, knowing that something has changed, and you hold up a looking glass for her to see. She laughs aloud, a sound you haven't heard from her in years. You can change your face at will, you say to her. Try it. Marilel nods, watching the looking glass carefully as her voice morphs into that of an old woman, then a homely beggar lady, then a Vargellan, and a dozen more. The last face you see is dark-haired, regal in bearing. It is the face of the Memovira. Accompanied by a distinct sense of hunger from the Bloom, the memory fades. The heart offers no explanation as to why it showed you this memory, but the implication is clear. The Memovira is merely a disguise, a mask that conceals the first cast-off. She has been alive, hiding behind a false identity for years. Wow. So we had to do all this... What is this for? We talked them into this for what? I mean... We're not getting any reaction from any of them, I mean, our companions. They're just standing there. I mean, how are they of use to me? I guess maybe I could have used them, their intellect and stuff instead? Yeah, that would have been a good idea, I guess. Alright. Not that I have, like, a gigantic amount compared to anyone else anyway, but... The Bloom tongues slide painlessly out of your body, setting you free. They show no further interest in you, and the whispering voices are gone from your mind. Except for this one. This one's, like, hanging around. Mazoth! It is you. Mazoth rises, clutching himself, and he abruptly vomits a clot of black fluid onto the glistening flesh beneath his feet. That's okay, it probably improved the decor. Small red wounds mar the flesh between the wires crisscrossing his chin. Gods, he growls. Gods! He looks up at you. His mechanical eye sockets spin, wheels within wheels, focusing on your face. You are the cast-off that was riding Zarian Daywalker. What the hell are you doing down here? How did you recognize me? Muscle movements, he says, grimacing. Small variations on expression. As good as a signature for those who know what to look for. He coughs more of the black fluid against the back of his wrist. You didn't answer me. What are you doing down here? I thought I was rescuing someone named Ishen, but here you are instead. Yeah, that's me. It's a nickname, short for Ishenazar, because I look like one. Whatever it is. But no one calls me that except... He pauses, smirks. The first sent you, didn't she? Not surprised. She won't be getting the resonance chamber working on her own. It's all too easy to destroy the damn thing if you don't know what you're doing. Something about the words, said in his voice, stirs a memory in you. Resonance chamber. Resonance chamber. The sensation builds. That's a memory from actually our life. We were trying to fix that thing, and now we're pretty far away from it. He winces, teeth clenched. Gods. The Bloom is a terrible host. Stuck its damn tongues into my guts to force-feed me. Fill my lungs with bile. Not sure what you did to get me out, but thank you. He spits a black-tinged wad of phlegm over his shoulder. Ptooey! Well, how do we get out of here? She's waiting. You know how she is. Hold on. How did you end up a prisoner to begin with? The Bloom took me, he says with a careless shrug. Not a surprise. It's not happy with the first, but you probably already know that. So it took me, because it knows I'm important to her. He says this casually, and without the faintest hint of pride. Anyway, I should get back to the first. She's going to be... He waves a hand. Well, you know. I don't know, actually. I thought I was working for the Memovira until just a few minutes ago. His expression goes wooden. Skist, he says, rubbing his forehead. Look, don't tell her I said anything. I don't need anyone shouting at me right now, let alone her. This is the worst headache I've ever had. But a headache is uncoiling through your head now as well. Alarm spreads over Mazoff's face, and he reaches out to catch you as you topple forward. Oops. You're underwater. The fading pulse of a sonar alarm ripples through the water, then is gone. An invisible pressure crushes your body, squeezing your head. A Jibra with a cast-off's tattoo rises from the dark to confront you. I should have known. You need something of ours to finish your resonance chamber, don't you, Father? He regards you with scorn. You haven't learned anything. You would sacrifice all of us for a chance at survival. You and the First. Pride blinds you both. You're wrong, Thom, you snarl. Yet his words frighten you. Is he saying Marilel's alive, with her own plan to stop the sorrow? She must be stopped. Any plan of hers would be dangerous. I've built the resonance chamber to save us all. It has the power to weaken the sorrow. I can kill the creature. A half-truth. The chamber certainly has the power, but who knows if it would be enough to kill. Will you apologize to me then, selfish child? Will you beg my forgiveness?
I'm ready to learn something new.
You lie. You always have, Thom says calmly. Although your motives differ, Marilel's plan and yours will result in the same end. The destruction of every last cast-off. I will not allow this to happen. He makes a complicated gesture with his fingers, and the pressure on your head increases. Thom's voice grows muffled and fades as your mind... Your sire's consciousness flees his imprisoned body, abandoning it to the Jibra in favor of a new host. Is it like in a... We're obviously underwater. Maybe we're at some depth. It's like removing the, I don't know how to say it. Like how you would go into a chamber to get... I know the words. It's just on the tip of my tongue. To get accustomed to the depth, and you have to like hang out in this chamber for a little while, and then you can come out, and you're accustomed to the, like, a pressurization chamber, yeah. So maybe it's like unpressurizing our body. Well, does someone go into this new body, or is it just explode? You return to consciousness, the headache fading. Your mouth tastes of seawater, of blood. Light and wet heat bathes the side of your face as the bloom opens a trans-dimensional portal. You can't be certain where it leads, but it's certainly your only way out. Someone, Mazov, is bracing you, holding you up. You alright? Mazov, what is the first plan with the chamber? To sever the... He gives you an odd look. You know, maybe you should ask her. I don't know enough about what's going on here. Just know that it'll free us from the sorrow, without sucking us all into someone else's mind. That should be enough. He shrugs. She can't do it without me, though. I'd best be getting back. Ooh, got another Mirrorcaster. Hey, get back here. Patting you awkwardly on the shoulder, he limps past you into the portal and vanishes. It's only when he's gone that you see the glittering contours of a small object lying where Mazov was standing. A Mirrorcaster. It must have fallen from Mazov's pockets. You wipe the slime from the joints of the machine and add it to your belongings. This spherical object is made of an unfamiliar gold-greenish metal. The object seems to be constantly moving, rotating in different directions, but when you hold it, you cannot feel the slightest hint of friction. You feel the click and whirl of countless mechanisms moving within the device, generating an almost intolerable heat.
I'll remember that.
We got a codex and quest updated. Return to the Maravira. I freed Ishen from the Bloom's heart. It turns out that he is actually Mazov, a fellow cast-off who I've encountered before, and the Maravira is really the first cast-off who has been hiding in the Bloom for years. It's time to return to her fortress and confront her. I saw a memory when I found Mazov. A Jibra cast-off named Thom told the Changing God that both his plans and the First would destroy all the cast-offs. My sire also said the resonance chamber could be used to weaken the sorrow, possibly enough to kill it. Sweet. Oh wait. Got codex. Forgot. Characters. Is it Mazov? Wires and tubes run through your brother Mazov's body. He has a special affinity, an almost spiritual connection for machines. He was captured by the Jibra during a raid on one of Emrah Jolios' treasure troves and was abandoned by his ally, the Changing God. No, it's not under Ishen, because we learned that he is Ishen. Just checking quickly to see if any of these... No, I don't think so. Yep, that's it. Oh, we can level up. What skills do we have? Basic stuff here. Or how about abilities? Onslaught. Flash. Really? I'm untrained in Flash? I thought... never mind. I'll take Maelstrom.
My understanding has increased.
Good. Now luck understanding increased. You guys have anything to say?
I'm still thinking about what happened down there. You know, in the heart of this place. This thing. This place.
The bloom seemed like the perfect place to sacrifice myself. He says this calmly. His eyes are glazed and weary, but I'm whole. I'm alive. And not through lack of trying. He frowns. It's surprising. I'm getting myself in your hurry. You want to die? Yes, he says cheerfully. Well, no. I want to almost die. Or to die and come back from the dead at the last minute. Yes, that. He kicks at the ground. But instead I keep on living. It's disappointing. Like death itself has stopped paying attention to me. You're not dying as long as I'm around. Aerith's opinion of you has improved, if that's even possible. We have gold tied and silver raised a small amount. That doesn't make any sense, he says gently. We all die. Some of us sooner than others. Sooner than we'd really like. For a long moment he is silent, his glow dim. Then, it's almost as though you had your own story in this. A separate one. That mine isn't the only one worth hearing. He touches your shoulder carefully, then looks you in the eyes. Be honest with me. Am I the only hero or not? I'm not gonna say that. We are both heroes. Should I lie and feed into his... He wants to be the only hero. So I'm not going to tell him we're all heroes. But this is kind of lying, so I'm going to compromise and say that we are both heroes, Aretas. We each have our own story. And maybe everyone is the hero of their own story? He freezes, and his mouth falls open. What a wonderful idea. I hope it's true. I guess maybe we could have told him that. Aretas' aura reignites, but it's not his normal manic glow. The timbre of it has changed somehow. That must be it. A hero, then, not only makes stories, but protects others as well. Gives them time to let their stories grow. And those things inside him think, the hero has a new and noble purpose. We don't like it. Of course you don't. Something else. How are things between us? You don't even need to ask, he says. His eyes glisten with the barest hint of tears. I'd think we were twins if we didn't have different parents. Aww. He blinks. I don't know if there's anything new to say about the people. Opinions? I love giving those. Calistige. She's really smart and beautiful, but I don't understand half of what she says. Tyvir. He has a kind heart. I can't tell you how often he helps me spend my money. Oh, alright. Alright, Tyvir.
Yes, lass.
How are you holding up? Are you sure I don't want to talk about what happened with Orvin? Not now. Not yet. Okay. Calistese? She adores me. Okay. Alright, so this... Oh, we can't tell where it goes. For the first time. I do want to look at that thing, that mirror caster, but let's go through. I'm guessing nothing else is here. We can mess with those again? I don't even know. Let's go. Because it's kind of too late now. Oh, that's the one we came through, right? Anything new with Trachogen? Let me just see.
Action! Here I come!
Does she let us sleep for free, I think?
A little more of that.
You're fully healed.
Villains, trouble coming your way.
Nah. Alright, let me run over here, see if she's selling anything. Because we used a lot of items. She has, yeah, we don't have anything. So nothing new anyway. But we can sell this crap. Spirit Shroud we've replaced. No one else can use it, so. I just want to hold on to this healing sword for now. It's not like we need the money. There's not much we can buy. All this stuff. I don't know why I'm talking to him. Okay, you know what? Let me go into this Mirrorcaster. Let's check it out. Where was it again? Here it is, a frictionless one. Oh, that's right, it looks like a sphere. The Mirrorcaster is hot to the touch. You feel the click and whirl of countless mechanisms moving beneath your hands. The urge to explore the mirror within is as palpable as thirst. Inspect. The clicking of the mechanisms with the device is a rhythmic thing, like a drum beat, like soldiers marching in perfect, helpless unison. Ditto. Okay. Entree.